So with this new generation of consoles, there's a lot of talk and fanfare about ray tracing, but what exactly is it? And should you even care about it? Ray tracing makes light look more realistic, which sounds basic, but it has a lot of knock-on effects for games. It isn't only better looking sunbeams or sunrises that benefits from ray tracing. You get mirrors that actually reflect the world around you as you're playing. Look down at a puddle, and ray tracing should allow you to see your character's face staring right back at you. Games will finally be able to replicate the sea properly, and shadows will look more dynamic. Think of a rising sun over a forest. With ray tracing, shadows are directly affected by the light source and will move according to the sun's position in the sky. Dark environments or fireworks will also look more realistic. Imagine being in a tomb with a flickering candle as the only source of light, or a fireworks display going off around you. Ray tracing sounds simple in principle, but in practice there is a lot that game developers can do with it. So as you can probably guess, ray tracing is all about making a game look as good as possible or more immersive due to it being more realistic. If you don't really care about hyper-realistic games, then maybe it's not something worth worrying about at the moment. It can also depend on what type of game you're playing. Fortnite, you might have ray tracing available to you, but do you really need it in the game? You'd probably appreciate it more in something like Cyberpunk, but even then, how much attention will you give a reflection when the whole room is exploding around you? Another thing to consider is if you prefer your games to run at a higher frame rate to look buttery smooth, then you might have to make some very difficult performance choices. So to give you an example, playing Battlefield 5 in full HD, not even in 4K, with no ray tracing, the game held an approximate frame rate of around 130 FPS, which is helpful and quite good for a shooter. After activating ray tracing though, turning it on, the frame rate dropped to 80 FPS on average. That's a whopping 50 frames difference. Now obviously there are a lot of variables in this specific example, what PC specs we're using, the game, the level, etc. But you get the idea. If you want ray tracing, then you're gonna have to take a hit in performance somewhere. Now saying that, the efficiency of graphics cards are always improving with things like DLSS being introduced to reduce the performance loss. So in future, it'll obviously become less of an issue, but for now, you might have to decide between pretty gaming and responsive gaming. No. A high-end gaming PC will be better than the new generation of consoles, but you're going to have to pay for it. For the price, it's amazing what PlayStation and Xbox can accomplish with their consoles, and the ray tracing they can do looks great. However, if the best graphics mean a lot to you, and you want to play the games exactly how they look in all those fancy tech demos, then you'll have to ditch an affordable console and get a pricey PC build, costing you into the thousands. Unless you got a new high-end graphic card in the last year, you'll probably need to upgrade. Nvidia says that 5 GB arrays per second is the minimum amount of virtual light ideally required to fully illuminate a typical room in a video game environment. So the cheapest option to meet this minimum requirement for ray tracing is the 2019 RTX 2070 card. However, for a little more, you can get the 2020 RTX 3070 card. Either way, you're looking at around 400 to 500 just as a starting point. It's an expensive starting point for ray tracing, but just highlights the value of consoles and what you have to pay to be on the cutting edge with PC gaming. There is a big push right now to get most new games having ray tracing, but there's not as many games that have it as you might think, even with everybody saying it's the future of gaming. Nvidia has confirmed support for games such as Cyberpunk, Fortnite, Watch Dogs Legion, and Dying Light 2. So while there are not as many confirmed games at the moment for console or PC, what's more interesting is the older games adding ray tracing. Minecraft really shows off the difference it can make to an older game, even one that most people are used to and have played, and that doesn't have AAA game graphics. Ray tracing totally transforms these areas in Minecraft to make it look like another game. If you do get a brand new AAA game, there is no guarantee that it'll actually have ray tracing. Over the last few years, game developers have got really good at making the most out of games without ray tracing, so you might not be able to tell. If you're unsure, you can always just Google it. it's tracing each ray of light, hence the name ray tracing. So the computer has to trace every single beam of light, see what it hits or passes through, determine how it changes color or angle or whatever, and then where it ends up. In real time, as you're shooting, a bunch of aliens and explosions are going off everywhere. Every line of light is being tracked and calculated. There's no wonder it takes a toll on the computer. There is so much processing going on. So hopefully this has helped you decide whether ray tracing is actually that important to you and it's worth your time or your money.